Hello everyone. My name is Chef Didar Singh, Assistant Professor, Chitkara School of Hospitality. As we know, hygiene is a series of practices performed to preserve health. According to the World Health Organization, hygiene refers to the conditions and practices that help to maintain health and prevent the spread of diseases. Personal hygiene refers to maintaining the body cleanliness. Many people equate hygiene with cleanliness, but hygiene is a broad term. It includes such personal habits and choices as how frequently to take a shower or bath, wash hands, trim fingernails, and wash clothes. It also includes attention to keeping surfaces in the home and workplace, including bathroom facilities, clean and pathogen-free. During this session, we'll be discussing about the personal and the professional hygiene. This session will provide information about the importance of hygiene. It will help to understand the requirements for personal hygiene, work area hygiene, and basic first aid. Knowledge and skill outcomes of this session are: first, understand the concept of hygiene and its importance. Second, know about what personal hygiene is. Third, know about what work area hygiene is. And third, to understand the basic first aid. Broadly talking about the learning outcomes in the concept of hygiene and its importance, you will be able to understand the importance of hygiene and know the concept of hygiene in bakery. In personal hygiene, you will be able to understand the necessity of personal hygiene and know how to keep personal hygiene. In work area hygiene, you will know the requirements for work area hygiene and the importance of work area hygiene. And if we talk about the basic first aid, you'll be able to understand the requirements to learn the first aid, know the basic do's and don'ts for first aid, learning to cure some common ailments. The word hygiene. The word hygiene is derived from Greek word hygieia, meaning the goddess of health. Hygiene is defined as a science and art of preserving and improving health. Hygiene deals with an individual and a community as a whole. Concept of hygiene is related to medical, personal, and professional practices and to most aspects of living. Maintaining hygiene is important in controlling and reducing the spreading of the disease and outbreak of unwanted health hazards. Hygiene practices are implemented for maintaining health and safety of people. Introducing good hygiene practices in day-to-day life are considered to be good habits by a society, while the neglect of hygiene can be considered disrespectful and even life-threatening. Let's now discuss the importance of hygiene. Hygiene plays a vital role in promoting and protecting the health and well-being of hundreds of people. The foods, materials, and equipments are subject to constant handling by people at every stage of food production and service. Therefore, helps in maintaining mental, social, and physical well-being. Let's now talk about personal hygiene. Personal hygiene is the term used for improvement of hygiene of an individual. For example, making sure that you wash your hands using antibacterial soap and dry with a single-use paper towel. It is the responsibility of a food handler to take extra care that personal bacteria are not added to the food. The major sources of transfer of bacteria can be hair, skin, teeth, and clothes. All food handlers must be fresh, well-groomed, and clean. While talking about personal hygiene, few points for food handlers that they must follow to maintain personal hygiene are: The food handlers should take bath daily and even twice a day, as body odor is offensive. Food handlers should brush teeth twice a day after meal. While handling food, they should wear clean headgears and prevent touching their scalp. They should not wear any jewelry, as they can harbor bacteria in food. Nails should be trimmed on regular basis and nail polish should be avoided. Feet should be washed and kept clean. Always wear clean socks to avoid perspiration. Food handlers should avoid touching of food when unwell or sick. They should be excluded from work until medical clearance is taken. Let's now talk about work area hygiene. It is also important to maintain the work area hygiene, as it is one of the best ways to protect food from contamination. Keep your work area and equipment clean. Wash them after each use as and when you begin to work with a new type of food, as any time contamination can occur. Some ways to keep your workplace clean are regular cleaning of the workplace, example, sweeping and dusting. Regular cleaning and maintenance of the equipment and utensils. Proper garbage disposal on a regular basis. Develop a pest control system. The example can be of pet or flesh. All the cracks and crevices should be sealed or fixed. There should be wire mesh on the windows. The other important topic to discuss is the basic first aid. First aid can be defined as the first assistance or treatment given to a casualty for an injury or sudden illness before the arrival of an ambulance or qualified medical assistance or expert. The aims of first aid are to save and preserve life. The second, to prevent the worst conditions of the patient. And third, to promote recovery of the patient. Let's talk about some do's and don'ts to be followed while giving first aid to the patient. Some do's to be followed are: do not get panic. Be calm and logical. Ask someone to get a doctor. Build up trust in the patient through communication. Never leave the patient alone. Continue to talk to the patient until ambulance or doctor arrives. Inform the relatives of the patient. Now, some don'ts to be followed are: Do not touch the wound with fingers or any other instrument. Do not put unclean dressing or cloth on the wound. Do not allow any crowd to be followed around the patient. Do not remove any clothes unnecessarily. Do not neglect any fracture or shock. After discussing the first aid and various do's and don'ts while doing first aid, let's now discuss about some common ailments that we can prefer during various situations, like cuts and wounds, minor burns, fainting and choking. Cuts and wounds. This is one of the most common problems faced and is caused by many reasons. They may sometimes cause infection. If not treated properly, it can lead to excess of blood loss. The wounds should be cleaned with warm water and then dried. Apply antiseptic cream and cover with a sterilized dressing. Minor burns. For minor burns, hold the injured area under cold water. Do not apply any oil and do not cover with any cloth. Just apply antiseptic ointment. Fainting. Fainting takes place due to reduced blood supply to the brain. The movement of a person should be avoided. Make sure that there is plenty of fresh air. Get the patient seated in a manner that the head is between the knees and hold it there for a minute. Make him down with the head at a slightly lower level than the feet. Choking. This is the most common problem in children as well as adults, as the food goes down the wrong way and may choke the food pipe. In case of choking, make the patient stand first, and the first aider should stand behind the patient and wrap his arms around the chest. Wrap the wrist on your other hand against the abdomen, slightly above the navel and below the ribcage. Rest your wrist on the patient's abdomen. Repeat it several times till the foreign body expels out of the windpipe. Hygiene is a concept related to cleanliness and health. It is as well related to personal and professional care practices. Hygiene practices are employed as preventive measures to reduce the incidence and spreading of disease. Hygiene practices vary, and what is considered acceptable in one culture might not be acceptable in another. The term cleanliness and hygiene are often used interchangeably, which can cause confusion. In general, hygiene refers to the practices that prevent spread of disease-causing organisms. Cleaning processes remove infectious microbes as well as dirt and soil, and are thus often the means of to achieve hygiene. In the manufacturing of food and other products, good hygiene is a critical component of quality assurance. Thank you for listening.